bellows to cool gypsies thus. Look where they come, take a look at them, and you shall see in him the triple pillar of the world transformed and whose strength is full. Behold and see.
If it be love indeed, tell me how much.
There's beggary in the love that can be reckoned. Then must thou find out new earth, new heaven to measure the extent of my love for you.
News, my good lord, from Rome.
Grates me the sum.
Nay, hear them, Antony. Fulvia, your wife, perchance is angry, or who knows if the scarce bearded Caesar Octavian hath sent his powerful mandate to you. Do this or this.
Let Rome and the Tiber melt, and let the wide arch of my ranged empire fall. Here is my space.
Excellent falsehood. Why did he marry Fulvia and not love her? I'll seem the fool, though I am not. Antony will be himself.
What's for tonight?
Hear the ambassadors.
Fie, wrangling queen. No messenger but thine. And tonight we'll wander through the streets and note the qualities of people. Come, my queen. Speak not to us.
I am so sorry, but I will hope of better deeds tomorrow. Rest you happy.
Lady Alexis, sweet Alexis, where's the soothsayer that you pray so to the queen? Soothsayer!
Yo, Will.
Is this the man? Is you, sir, that know things?
In nature's infinite book of secrecy, a little I can read.
Show him your hand. Good sir, give me good fortune.
I make not but foresee.
Pray then, foresee me one.
You shall be far fairer than you are.
He means in flesh.
Vex out his presides, be attentive.
You shall be more beloving than beloved.
I'd rather heat my liver with drinking.
Nay, hear him.
Let me have a child of 50, to whom Herod of Jewry made you homage. Bind me to marry with Octavius Caesar, and companion me with my mistress.
You shall outlive the lady whom you serve.
Oh, excellent, I love long life better than figs.
You have seen and proved a fairer form of future than witches to approach.
Out, fool! I forgive thee for a witch! Nay, come tell Iris hers.
Your fortunes are alike.
But how? But how? Give me particulars.
I have said.
Am I not an inch of fortune better than she? Our worser thoughts heaven's meant. Oh, Alexis, come, her fortune. Oh, let her marry one that cannot go. Good Isis, hear me this prayer, though thou deny me in matter of more weight. Good Isis, I beseech thee.
Amen, dear goddess, hear that prayer of the people.
Amen.
Hush, here comes Antony.
Not he, the queen.
See you, my lord? Was he not here?
No, madam.
He was disposed to mirth, but then, on the sudden, a Roman thought hath struck him. Enobarbus? Seek him, and bring him hither. Where's Alexis?
Here at your service, my lord approaches.
We will not look upon him. Go with us.
Fulvia, thy wife, first came into the field.
Against my brother Lucius?
Aye, but soon that war had ended. And the time state made friends of them, joining their forces against Octavian's, whose better in the war from Italy upon the first encounter drave them.
Well, what worst?
Labienus, this is stiff news. Ha! With his Parthian force, he extended Asia from the Euphrates. His conquering banner shook from Syria to Lydia and to Ionia.
Antony, thou wouldst say? Stayed in Egypt. Fare thee well a while.
At your noble pleasure.
A man from Sicyon, he stays upon your will.
Let him appear. These strong Egyptian fetters I must break, or lose myself in dotage.
Fulvia, thy wife, is dead.
Where died she?
In Sicyon. Her length of sickness, with what else more serious, imparted thee to know, despairs.
Forbear me. There's a great spirit gone.
The hand that could plug her back that shoved her on.
I shall break the cause of expedience to the queen. For Fulvia's death, with more urgent touches, do strongly speak to us. Pompey hath given the dare to Octavian, who commands the empire of the sea. And the sides of the world may danger, much as breeding. And to those whose place is under us, do require a quick remove from hence.
Where is he?
I did not see him since.
See where he is, who's with him, and what he's doing. I did not send you.
If you find him sad, say I am dancing.
If in mirth, report that I am sunsick. Quick, and return.
Madam, methinks if you did love him dearly, you don't hold the methods to enforce the life from him.
What should I do?
In each thing, give him way. Cross him nothing.
Thou teachest like a fool
the way to lose him. Tempt him not so too far. I wish, forbear. In time we hate that which we often fear.
But here comes Antony. I am sick and sullen.
I'm sorry to give breathing to my purpose.
Help me away, dear Charmian. I shall fall. It cannot be this long. The sides of nature will not sustain it.
Now, dearest queen.
Pray you, stand further from me.
What's the matter?
I know, by that same eye, there's some good news. What says the married woman? Your wife, Fulvia? Let her not say 'tis I that keep you here. I have no power upon you. Hers you are.
Cleopatra.
Why should I think you can be mine and true?
Most sweet queen.
Nay, pray you, seek no color for your going, but bid farewell and go. Eternity was in our lips and eyes, bliss in our brows bent. They are so still. Or thou, the greatest soldier in the world, art turned the greatest liar.
Hear me, queen! The strong necessity of time commands my services a while, but my heart remains in full services with you. Rome shines o'er in civil war. Pompey makes his approaches to the port of Rome. And that which with you should most safe my going is Fulvia's death.
Though age from folly could not give me freedom, it does from childishness. Can Fulvia die?
She's dead, my queen. Look here, and at thy sovereign leisure, read.
A most false love. Now I see, and Fulvia's death, how mine received shall be.
Precious queen, forbear, and give true evidence to my love, which stands in honorable trial.
But, sir, forgive me. Your honor calls you hence, so therefore be deaf to my unpitied folly. And all the gods go with you, and upon your sword sit laurel victory, and smooth success be shrewd before your feet.
Residing here, ghost with me yet, and I, hence fleeting, will remain here with thee. Away.
You may see Lepidus, and henceforth know. It is not my natural vice to hate. Our great competitor from Alexandria, Antony. This is the news. He fishes, drinks, and wastes the lamps of night and revel.
I must not think these are evils. Even now, deserving all his goodness.
You were too indulgent.
Here's more news.
Thy biddings have been done, most noble Octavian. Pompey is strong at sea, and it appears he's beloved of those that only have feared yourself. To the ports, these decontents are moving.
I should have known no less.
Octavian, I bring thee word. Menecrates and Minas, famous pirates, make the sea serve them. No vessel can peep forth. 'Tis as soon taken and seen. Pompey's name strikes more than could his war resisted.
Assemble we immediate council. Pompey thrives in her idleness.
Tomorrow, Octavian, I shall be furnished to inform you rightly. But by sea and land I can be able to front by this present time.
Till which encounter, it is my business too. Farewell.
me to drink, Mandragora.
Why, madam?
That I may sleep out this great gap of time my Antony is away.
You think of him too much.
Oh, Charmian, where thinkest thou he is now? The demi atlas of the earth, the arm and bouillonet of men?
Saverna v. Detail.
How goes it with my brave Mark Antony?
The last thing he did, dear queen, he kissed the last of many double kisses, this orient pearl.
Mine ear must pluck it thence.
Good friend, quoth he, see the firm Roman to great Egypt sends, this treasure of an oyster.
What? Was he sad or merry?
He was nor sad nor merry.
Get me ink and paper, Charmian. Welcome, my good Alexis.
Did I, Charmian, ever love Julius Caesar so?
Oh, that brave Caesar, that valiant Caesar.
By Isis, I will give thee bloody teeth. If thou with Caesar paragon again, my man of men.
By your most gracious pardon.
But come away, get me ink and paper. He shall have every day a several greeting, or I'll unpeople Egypt.
If the great gods be just, they shall assist the deeds of justice, men.
No, worthy Pompey, that what they do delay, they not deny.
Whilst we are suitors to their throne, decays the thing we sue for.
We, ignorant of ourselves, often beg our own harms, which the great gods deny us for our own good.
I shall do well as the new ruler of Rome. The people love me, and the sea is mine. My powers are rising. Mark Antony will make no wars. Octavian gets money where he loses hearts. Lepidus flatters both, of both tis flattered, but he neither loves nor either cares for him.
Octavian Lepidus are a mighty strife.
Where have you this? Tis false.
From Silvia, sir.
Oh, he dreams. I know they are in Rome together looking for Antony. Salt Cleopatra. Let witchcraft join with beauty, lust with both. How now?
Mark Antony is every hour in Rome expected.
I could have given less matter, a better ear. His soldiership is twice the other two.
I cannot hope Octavian and Antony shall well agree together. His wife did trespasses to Octavian. His brother warred upon him, although, I think, not moved by Antony.
I know not, Minos, how lesser hostilities may give way to greater. Were it not that we stand up against them all. Come.
'Tis a worthy deed, and shall become you well to entreat your Captain Antony to soft and gentle speech.
I shall entreat him to answer like himself.
Your speech is passion, but pray you stir no embers up. Here comes the noble Antony.
And yonder Octavian.
Noble friends, that which combined us was most great, and let not a leaner action bind us apart. What amiss between us when we come together to debate our trivial differences about?
'Tis spoken well. Were we before our armies than to fight, I would do thus.
Welcome to Rome.
Thank you.
Your wife and brother made wars upon me, and their contestation was theme for you.
My brother never did urge me in this fact. If you'll patch a quarrel as whole you have to make it with, make it not with this. You have a third of the world. You may pay easy.
I wrote to you when you were carousing in Egypt. You did pocket up my letters, and with taunts did flout my messenger.
Sir, he fell upon me without invitation. You see, I had just come from a banquet with three kings. The wine spoke rather than I. And the next day, I told him of myself. Let this fellow be nothing of our strife.
You have broken the article of your oath, which you shall never have tongue to charge me with.
Soft, Octavian. No, Lepidus. Let him speak.
To lend me arms when I required them, the which you both denied.
Neglected, rather. Truth is that Fulvia, to have me out of Egypt, made wars here. And I, the ignorant motive, do so ask forgiveness as stooping in such a case.
'Tis worthily spoken.
If it might please you to enforce no further the grease between ye, to forget them quite, were to remember that the present need speaks to atone you.
'Tis nobly spoken, Mechanus.
Or, if you borrow one of his love for the instant, you may, when you hear no more words of Pompey, return it again.
Thou art a soldier only. Speak no more.
I do not much dislike the matter, but we shall remain in friendship. Yet if I knew what hoop should hold us staunch, from edge to edge of the world I would pursue it.
Give me leave, Octavian.
Speak, Agrippa.
Thou hast a sister by the mother's side, admired Octavia. Great Mark Antony is now a widower.
Say not so, Agrippa, if Cleopatra heard you.
No, Octavian, I am not married. Let Agrippa further speak.
To hold you in perpetual amity, to make you brothers, to knit your hearts with an unslipping knot, take Antony, Octavia, to wife, whose beauty claims no worse a husband than the best of men.
Will Octavian speak?
Not till he hears though Antony is touched by what is spoke already.
Gives me thy hand. From this hour, our hearts may be governed in the loves of brothers.
There is my hand. A sister I bequeath you, whom no brother did ever love so dearly. Let her live to join our kingdoms and our hearts.
Happily.
Amen.
I did not think to draw my sword against Pompey, for he hath laid strange courtesies and great of late upon me.
Of us most, Pompey, presently be soft.
What is his strength by land?
Great and increasing, but by sea he is an absolute master.
So is the fame. Haste we for it?
With most gladness, and do invite you to my sister's view. Whither straight, I'll lead you.
Let us, Lepidus, not lack your company.
Noble Antony, not sickness shall detain me.
Good evening, Barbin. Welcome from Egypt, sir.
Half heard of Octavian, where the Mechanus, my honorable friend Agrippa, the other half.
Good evening, Barbus. We have cause to be glad that matters are so well digested. You stayed well bite in Egypt.
Aye, sir. We did sleep the night out of countenance, amid the night light with drinking.
Cleopatra's a most triumphant lady, if report be square to her.
But Mark Antony, when she first met Mark Antony, she pressed up his heart upon the river of Cindus.
There she appeared indeed, or my reporter devised well for her.
I will tell you. The barge she sat in like a burnished stone, burned on the water. The upper deck was beaten gold. Purple the sails, and the oars were silvered. Cleopatra was indescribable. On either side of her stood pretty dimpled boys like smiling cupids, with colored fans whose wind did seem to cool, the delicate cheeks which they did cool.
Oh, rare for Antony.
Her gentlewoman, like the Nereides, so many mermaids tended to her. From the barge, a strange invisible perfume hits the sense like of the adjacent wharves. Her city cast her people out upon her, and Antony did sit alone at the marketplace, whistling to the air, which, but for vacancy, had gone to gaze at Cleopatra too.
Rare Egyptian.
Upon her landing, Antony sent to her and invited her to supper. He replied, it should be better he became her guest.
Royal wench.
Now Antony must leave her utterly.
Never, he will not.
If beauty, wisdom, modesty can settle the heart of Antony, Octavia is a blessed lottery to him.
Good evening, Barbus. Make yourself my guest whilst you abide here.
Humbly, sir. Thank you. The world and my great office will sometimes divide me from your bosom.
All which time, before the gods, my knees shall bow my prayers to them for you.
Good night, sir. My Octavia. Good night.
Good night.
Now, sirrah, you do wish yourself in Egypt.
But I have never come thence, nor you thither.
Say to me, then, whose fortunes shall rise higher? Mine or Octavian's?
Octavian.
Speak this no more.
To none but thee, no more. But when to thee, if thou dost play with him at any game, thou art sure to lose.
Get thee gone! The soothsayer speaks the truth. The very dice obey him. For with Octavian, if I am to play at him with any game, I am sure to lose. Now, I will to Egypt. And though I make this marriage for my peace, in Egypt my pleasure lies.
As I conceive the journey, we'll be at the mouth before you, Lepidus.
Your way is short. My purpose do draw me much about. You will win 2 days upon me.
Sir, good success.
Great success.
Farewell.
Good madam, keep yourself within yourself. The soldier is innocent.
Some innocence escape not the
before we fight. To you, all three, scourge the ingratitude that despiteful wrong cast on my noble father.
Be pleased to tell us how you take the offers we have sent you.
You have made me offer of Sicily, Sardinia, and I must rid all the seas of pirates, then to send measures of wheat to Rome. Once that agreed upon, to part with unhacked edges and bear back my forces undinted.
That's our offer.
Know then, I came before you here a man prepared to take this offer. But Mark Antony has put me to some impatience. You must know, when Octavian and your brother were at blows, your mother came to Sicily and did find her welcome friendly.
I have heard it, Pompey, which I do owe you.
Give me thy hand. I did not think, sir, to have met you here. Aboard my galley, I invite you all. Will you lead, lords?
Show us the way, sir.
Come.
You and I have no battle, sir.
Let's see it, then.
We have, sir.
You've done well by water.
And you by land.
We can't have to fight with you.
For my part, I'm sorry it's turned to a jerky. Pompey doth this day laugh with his fortunes. We look not for Mark Antony. Here, pray you, is he married to Cleopatra?
Octavian's sister is now the wife of Antony.
Then he and Octavian forever knew together?
Antony will to his Egyptian dish again. He will use his affection where it is needed. You're married but for this occasion.
And thus it may be. Come, sir, will you aboard? I have a health for you. Come, let's away.
Sound out.